שלום תלמידים, and ברוכים הבאים to רגע בעברית. We are concluding this week the book of Genesis with the interesting story of the blessing that is given over the two children of Joseph, Ephraim and Menashe. In this particular verse, we read in the Torah portion in chapter 48, verse 16, an interesting words by Jacob himself. After blessing Ephraim and Menashe, the sons of Yosef, he says, "Amalach agoel oti mikol ra yevarech et anarim." Vayikara ba'em shmi. The interesting words that are being used here is this word malach. Who is the one that Jacob called upon to bless those children? He used the word ibu malach. The word malach is resembling the word melech, actually. What is the word melech? Melech is a king. Malach is sometimes translated as angel, but literally mean messenger. A malach does not have to be an entity with a little heavenly wings flying around, but on the contrary, a malach literally, by the Evan Shushan dictionary, is one who is a messenger. Who is the Malach that he is talking about? Notice he used the word Goel. It's not a regular Malach. It's not a regular messenger. He's a redeeming. The word Goel comes from the Hebrew word Geula, redeeming. The redeeming, there's the correct way to read this verse, the redeeming messenger, the one that was a redeeming messenger to me, he is the one who actually going to bless those boys. So when the redemption occurred to Abraham, remember that earlier in Genesis, he is wrestling with a malach, okay? This malach that he's fighting with, he is calling the redeeming messenger. Who is this Malach? Well, our sages come and explain to us that this Malach is actually none other than the Messiah himself. You want to know who is the one who blessed him? He is the one who is called the Messiah. He is known by the name the Lad, the Na'ar, the Lad, and here he's calling upon this name, and he's saying in the text, "Amalach Agoel Oti." And it's interesting the language. He doesn't say who the one who redeemed me. Gaal is redeemed in the past. Goel is redeeming in the present. He said the messenger who is redeeming me right now. This is interesting. Redemption is not a one-time thing, but a redemption is a continuous thing that is happening here in the life of Yaakov. And he said the angel, the messenger, who is redeeming me continuously from every evil, he is the one who is going to redeem those children. Interestingly enough, this blessing says every Friday night over our children. May our children will be like Ephraim and Menashe. But do you know that Ashkenazic Jews say this blessing every night before they go to bed? This is a blessing that passed to all of us through Jacob, so we will walk into the coverage and protection and redemption of the Messiah himself. It is not a one-time thing, a redemption. No, if you redeemed yesterday, we are to ask the Lord to redeem us today and tomorrow and the next day. So there is something interesting here. He inviting his grandchildren to walk into a personal covenant with the redeeming angel. We also have to remember the power of the redeeming angel, or messenger in this case. He redeemed us, he redeeming us, and he will redeem us in the future. I hope you enjoyed this special episode of Rega Bivrit, and as we finish the book of Genesis, let's remember the power of this redeeming messenger. Litraot.